I'm not taking this shirt off.
Tell me, don't cry. Nikal.
What?
What the fuck? I'm not doing it.
I'm not doing it.
Hi guys, I'm Vibhu Raghav और Unwrap with Vibhu में आपका स्वागत है और आज के जो दो हमारे guests हैं, of course you love them, I love them because they are the cutest, most adorable Tom and Jerry jodi that we know. So let's welcome Aneri Vajani and Mishkat Verma. Hi guys.
Hey Vibhu. Hi guys. Hi.
So
hi.
Thanks a lot for doing this after almost 1 year.
Thank you for having us here, bro.
That
after 1 year, that's Aneri's fault, bro. She keeps fighting with me for no reason.
He keeps fighting with me and then we've never done this.
I call them Tom and Jerry for a reason.
Who's Tom, who's Jerry?
I think I'm Jerry and you're Tom.
How does it matter?
It doesn't really matter. So, of course, a lot of you know that we all worked on the same show together. So, I have to bring up something in the name of the most memorable moment with these two guys. So Aneri and I, the first week of the shoot for Nisharo's cousins, and we were shooting in Jaipur, and the first day of shoot for both of us, it's something around 48 degrees or something, and we have to run up stairs on a fort wall. So there's a thick wall, which is Nahargarh Fort, which is a staircase, and we have to run up. Of course, there's retake, and at some point she said, "Vibhu, I'm gonna faint. Vibhu, I'm gonna faint." And next thing I know, she fainted. She fainted.
I told him, Vibhu, I'm gonna faint, and just make sure ki mere muh ko kuch na ho. My face has to be.
Aur kitna kuch hua tere muh ko, yaar.
Talk about yourself, not me.
Bichari, it's okay.
So I was running, and I fainted. And the next thing I remember is getting up at the Nahargarh Fort, and some air from somewhere was coming, and I thought I was in like some hotel room or something, but aisa kuch nahi hua.
Okay. We had to start shooting again. And about Mishkat, my most, in fact, the first memory with him is, of course, the first week that you were shooting. Mm-hmm. And he walked in and he introduced himself to everybody. And I think it took you 2 days to become part of the family. Like, he is the most amiable guy I know. Like, he's so down to earth and friendly.
What?
Amazing. Yeah, it's
I'm underground. I'm not down to earth. I'm too humble.
With me, it's like that.
No, you have this wrong thing about Mishkat. Ek to, like when you meet him, he'll behave like just so sophisticated and like, oh, very actor types. And very,
I'm not actor type at all. Mishkat, that's the worst thing you tell me. What is actor type?
Yeah, what is actor type?
First ever Aneri on the show. What is Aneri? Aneri, wait. First ever Aneri, okay? I came for the look test, okay?
Mishkat, I'll just
snap it. Aneri comes, okay? Hi, Aneri.
I can't do this!
I have to go for my shot. I'm like loser.
Listen.
When she came on my show, when my first show as one of the 20 girls who came. So when she came
in the background.
I was so nice to her, even though I know that I am the hero out here, she's one of the people who've come just like.
You were nice to me because I was really bloody good.
Next.
No, but she is good with her talent, and so are you. So,
I. Yeah.
So, the thing is, you've worked so long together, like almost 1 year, all of us together on the show. What is that one thing that you've learned from each other?
Oh. Nothing.
Time to praise each other.
What have I learned from Mishkat?
I can say what I learned from Aneri.
I can say one, two things I've learned.
Mishkat, you go.
Aneri is like.
Honestly,
okay. Aneri is so bloody confident.
That she is.
In whatever she does, like, and she's crazy. She'll do anything, like, for a scene, for anything, like, she's just too damn confident. I don't know where she gets that from.
She's too invested when she's doing a scene.
No, that confidence in a person, like, I don't care, I know I'm too good. She's not arrogant, she's confident. That's one thing good about her.
Uh-huh.
So, that reminds me of an incident. So, in Jaipur shoot, first schedule, first week. So there was a scene, I was supposed to be riding like a scooter and two people including Aneri, I don't know who the third one is, Barbie. So Aneri and Barbie were supposed to be behind me, that was the script, mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. And of course at the shoot you changed stuff, so it was decided that Aneri will drive. She doesn't know how to drive. She's driving a scooter, Activa, with two people behind. in full traffic. And she's like, I'll do it.
That's what I'm saying.
And my heart just broke. I said, this will kill me. But damn, she did it. Her wrists were swollen, but she did it. That's really amazing.
Oh my god, I feel... Ah!
Okay, what have you learned from him? Besides the English.
Dude, he made fun of you.
I know, but it's good. So, Mishkat, like I've worked with like a lot of actors and all of that, but actors ka aisa hota hai that if I am working more than like 12 hours, so call me after 12 hours, I'll not come before that, all of that. But Mishkat, the EP should just tell him that you've packed up at this time, 12 o'clock in the night, and you have to come at 6 o'clock in the morning. Mishkat would be there before anybody else. He was always on time, like, and he's never cribbed about it.
Yeah,
ever.
He's never been
never, there. Never, never, never cribbed about it. And,
that's the only thing you've learned?
Yeah, I've learned this that, not to crib about anything. And also that Mishkat is rude sometimes. With me especially, but then he also knows how to cover it up, and he covers up really well. Like if I'm rude with Mishkat, I don't know how to cover it up. But Mishkat has that charm in him, ki matlab you can't be really angry with him.
Oh my god, that's a lot of tarif. So on that, I want to ask you, what is that one thing that you want to change in each other?
Oh, that I have an answer ready, but if you get offended, I'm going to say.
No, tell me.
But I keep telling you recently that you... Yaar, first you go there.
No, Aneri, I want to say.
Change in Aneri is that she's too unorganized.
Punctuality.
Yeah, she's...
I came at sharp 8:30.
Yeah. Like, she's very nice, irritating. Like, she's so unorganized and she's like... every time. Like... that's okay, that's her. What I like about her, she's not conscious about the fact that she's like that. She gives a damn about what people are thinking about her. Phir tarif ho gayi. Shit, buri baat ho gayi. Haan. To, thoda jhoot bolti hai ye. Main tere ko bola hai. Like, I'm scary because ye jhoot bolti na, bade safai se jhoot bol deti
hai. I like to people.
She feels it well.
No, I only lie to people that I'm really close to.
But you agree you lie?
You lie. Yeah, I lie. And I don't lie to some other extent. I lie like some normal...
For small things, just because I don't want
you to get hurt, na, Mishkat. That's more important.
Mera muh mat khulwa. Teen camera chalu hai.
So, I lie because I don't want that other person to get hurt. Yeah. Or, you know, I just lie because
and
of
the
that.
Best part
and
is
I also lie because I don't want to lose that person.
कुछ भी बोल रही तो अभी मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ the best part is I know she's lying
just shut up
अबे अच्छा ठीक है अच्छा ठीक
अनेरी your turn
मेरे बारे में क्या चेंज करेगी
तू something I want to change about Mishkat
this is your moment don't just give it away
think so much I don't think at all
yeah अच्छा
मैं क्या करूँ?
चेनवार मिश्कात, yeah, I've got the point.
Better be good.
So, no, of course, you have screwed my case. You think I'll leave you?
Screw.
So, Mishkat apparently has this, like if Mishkat talks to me in a bad way, say, hey, that's okay. But if I do that to him, then listen, just talk to me properly. His ego gets hurt. Mishkat has a lot of ego problem for no reason.
Don't my friends are going to watch this. They're going to agree with her.
He has a lot of ego problem for no reason.
Like it's not ego.
Talking, no, but if you are talking like so badly with me and if I give it back to you, you can't give it to your ego. You're adding
so
to
the
ego.
So the playing field has to be even for both of us.
Exactly.
Right? Yeah? Yeah, so both the people, it has to be the same way.
Yeah.
I don't mean to be bad to you. You're doing it intentionally no. because I do it.
Just shut up. You always have ego problem. Always you have ego problem. Always.
Okay. That's a lot of tarif. And on tarif that note... On that note, we move to our first segment, which is BFF quiz. And of course,
BFF?
I'm gonna.
Kai ka BFF.
Aneri, we'll start with you. So, what is Mishkat's flat number?
Fuck off.
You've been there so many times.
It is C wing. I think house is on the first floor. But I don't know.
Okay, that's close. I'll give you that.
First floor,
yeah. I'll give you that. Who is he a bigger fan of, Shah Rukh or Salman?
I think not Shah Rukh, not Salman. He likes
Ranbir
Kapoor.
No, bigger. He asked you one.
The bigger fan, Shah Rukh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll give you that. So, what was Mishkat's character's name in his last TV show?
Raj.
No.
You piece of horse shit.
No, previous show. The first show. Okay, no.
Bubble. Yeah.
You got it. Raj.
Okay. Fine. Now comes a very important question. Is he a good kisser?
How will I know about it?
You must have heard things around. This is a small world.
You look good.
I think he should be.
Okay, Mishkat, we come to you.
Yeah, do not
we will not trouble her with that. Who is she a bigger fan of? Jennifer Aniston or Jennifer Lawrence?
Does she even know who they are?
Oh my god, I got a cramp.
Jennifer Aniston who? Jennifer Lawrence who? Ah,
you are such an ass! Do you know who they are? Yeah!
Okay, who's Jennifer Aniston?
Just say first one.
First one.
Yeah, she got the answer.
Jennifer Aniston, I think because she watches Friends. You know Jennifer?
Yeah, yeah.
Rachel and
yeah,
Friends?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Jennifer Lawrence also. Allah, you told me.
Mishkat, yeah!
Very, very good.
So, okay, Mishkat. What was her subject in college?
Like, has she been to college?
Oh, yes, I have, you donkey.
Oh. BFF quiz.
She's, kya ki padhi likhi lagti hai.
She's intelligent.
BMM?
BDM.
Pagal. Hade.
BMM nahi kiya.
मैंने आज किया था
मैं आज बोलने वाला था इतने इंटेलिजेंट बोल दिया इससे मैंने चला गया उधर आज तो मैंने भी किया मैं इंटेलिजेंट मेरे बाप ने भी आज किया इस बार इंटेलिजेंट
ओके सो हाउ मेनी लैंग्वेजेस डज शी स्पीक
शी गुजराती 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 हिंदी इंग्लिश थ्री
इंग्लिश इन द एंड
गुजराती
आई कैन स्पीक मराठी आल्सो You know, I'm winning the quiz just by the way.
She is winning.
Say, okay, Mishkat, say I love you in Marathi. You can speak Marathi.
Of course, I can speak Marathi.
Say, I love you in Marathi.
Aneri, love has no language.
Exactly.
Vibhu, bol I love you in Marathi.
Me tula khubat pyar karte.
Ghanta, me tula awadte.
Abe awadte na like you, donkey. Me tula khubat prem karte.
Tula pyar kyun bola pehle?
To main prem kar diya na.
Chal, theek, theek.
Okay, so what's her favorite cuisine?
Street food, she can have vada pav, samosa, Chinese bhel, uttappa, dosa idli. Food is her favorite cuisine, that's it. She can eat any damn thing.
That I will agree with.
Yeah.
So, coming back to conversation, Aneri, of course, we all know that how much you love Salman Khan. So, how was it meeting him for the first time?
Okay, so you've
met him. Yeah, I know. I just want to picture you people now.
So, I have a story actually behind this that whenever I wanted to meet Salman, like my friends knew Salman, like they could like easily make me meet Salman Khan. But I had a thing in my mind that I would want to meet Salman Khan through my work. So, when I was doing Rishaw's Ke Cousins, I remember that day I was really unwell and I had not gone for the shoot for the very first time. The shoot was cancelled because I was not well. And that very day I had to also go to meet Salman because Star Plus wanted me to have like an interaction with Salman Khan.
I remember my producers
called me saying, we know that you've not come for the shoot, but you should just go and meet him. So I was like, okay. And I went there and he was performing on stage. I was backstage looking at him. And the moment he got out, of course, I couldn't meet him that very moment. Then I got tired of waiting. So then I left because I was really unwell. Then some PR chick came to me from Star Plus saying, Salman is... now free and he's asked for you. And oh I was like, oh my god.
Salman
so then
has
asked for Aneri Vajani. So I was like, okay. So then I went running with my mom. My mom also was there with me. And I remember telling Salman that I had actually got Gajar ka halwa for him. But because I was so upset, I just kept it somewhere. Then I told him that Salman had got Gajar ka halwa for you. And what he told me in return was, baby, you need Gajar ka halwa, not me.
और बोला बहुत कम बोला थोड़ा और मेरे को समझ में नहीं आया
वो एडिट कर देगा
रिपीट
सो मिशकात व्हाट हैज बीन द टफेस्ट पार्ट कमिंग सो फार एज एन एक्टर लाइक व्हाट वाज द टफेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ इट
एवरी डे इज टफ मैन एज एन एक्टर यो स्पेशली इन in this city, because you know there are people who come from out of this city and who come here, and you know everyone is more talented, better looking, a better actor.
Yeah.
You think you're shit and you walk out there and you see people who are like 10 times better than you.
Maybe, but I don't think I'm really fierce or like amazingly talented. But there are guys who are far better. I don't have an answer to getting success here. Like, so it just feels terrible. There are days which are like horrible for me. Days which are good, like today when I'm with all of y'all. So yeah, just many moods for you as an actor.
So what are those three things or qualities that define you? Like, what are those three things?
I think firstly, I think I'm jolly grounded. Am I not, Mishkat?
I will give her that. But with all
why are you laughing then?
With all my heart, I will give her that. She is very grounded. Yes.
But I was going to something really nasty, so I'm not going to say that. Anyway, go on. You understand what I'm going to say?
No.
Okay, go on.
I don't understand.
Okay, go on, go on. Nah, you're very grounded.
So I think I'm very grounded and I take up work only if I think I will do justice to it and I will enjoy it, because I always believe that whatever work I'm doing, if I don't sleep peacefully, then that work is not worth it. So yeah, my work defines me. And lately a lot of people have told me that my smile is really cute. So my smile also defines me.
Oh my god, that's amazing. That is cute. Super cute. What about you, Mishkat?
I could have told you.
The three things that define you.
Define me as an actor or just generally
as
me?
As a person.
As me. I think that I am simple.
I'll give you that.
Yeah, I'm simple.
Yeah, I know you enough.
Wear funky clothes.
Huh? That I know. I'm simple, and then I'm not... I don't think much of what I've done in my life so far. I think if I have to reach from A to Z, I'm still on A. Which I genuinely feel like that. I'm not trying to be modest. And the third thing is that I have a better smile than Aneri.
Okay.
That is debatable, yes. But I think both of you are like amazing together with your smiles.
I think I'm a bit better.
Okay, I'll give
you
a smile.
Don't forget the smile. So, Aneri... she slapped me like 10 times so far.
The leverage. So, Aneri, there was a time you posted something on Instagram, a picture in a bikini, and there was a huge hue and cry about it. There were a lot of positive comments and there were a lot of negative comments. What is your conclusion to that whole experience today?
Okay, so I have never spoken about it till date, never ever spoken about it, because I remember the moment I posted that picture, they were like, a lot of media on the sets of Beha, then they really wanted to talk to me about it, and I had told the production house that I don't want to talk to anybody. And I've always believed that I don't want to regret what I do. So after posting the picture, it's been 2, 3, 4, 5 months maybe, and I don't regret it, because at that moment I wanted to post the picture like that and I posted it.
Yes.
So people who are talking about it, I was in papers, in news. And I posted that picture not to be on news. If that was the thing, I would have given a lot of interviews and spoken about it openly. And I remember when Mishkat, that is really very sweet. I'm not slapping you now. Very sweet of Mishkat to also, he posted a long message on the picture. So I just want to, that now that you've spoken, talked about it, I swear I have not spoken to anybody about it. I've always just shoot everybody that's my life, my rules. I can do whatever I want to do. So when I posted the picture, a lot of people had their thing that, oh, what the hell is she doing? Why are you posting such a picture? Do you have a body to post such a picture? So my thing is that my Instagram account, you are following me. So if you don't like it, don't like the picture or ignore the picture. But agar aap kiske baare mein achha nahi bol sakte, at least bura mat bolo.
Exactly.
It's my body. If I am okay with posting such a picture, so I think you all have... I'm not here to please anybody through my Instagram. I post pictures only if I like it.
And you know, the whole thing about that picture and the related controversy and everything is that I have to tell you something, that so much love came out for you.
Yeah.
So much support came out from you, from everybody, from him and from all the people we know, our friends and the fans and everybody. So I wanted to know what you think about it today, because I really wanted to hear something like that. It's your life, it's your rules, it's your body, you will decide what to do with it. And that's how life should be, like, especially with women. Like, it's all about taking life with the horns, you know, grabbing
like
it.
When I posted the picture also, I had never thought about ki, oh, now that posting it, toh, how many likes will I get, or what will people react on my picture, will they like it, will they not like it, because I was not posting that picture for anybody. That picture was posted just because I felt like doing it and I did it.
See, this is my answer when you ask me, why do you put topless pictures all the time?
Because in that moment
I take the shirt off and I'm like, okay, fine, I don't want to just post. There's no reason behind
exactly.
it, right?
If you don't like the picture, if you think that I'm too skinny, okay, yeah, I am skinny and I'm very confident about being skinny. I love the way I am, and of course I love the way I am, but also I want to improve and I will improve someday.
You will. Yeah. You're headed in that direction.
Yeah, I'm going towards that zone now.
What are the two most important things to chase in life? Like, which are the two most important things one should chase in life relentlessly? What are those two things?
For me, success. And success has to be chased. Come what may, you should get where you have to get. No excuses like destiny or luck. I don't believe in that at all.
Okay.
I might sound very mean, but
no,
I don't want to say
not
it.
Actually.
Yeah, I just think success should go after success, like, with whatever you can.
Relentlessly.
Yeah, exactly. And the second thing, after success, I don't know, I'll get flagged for this, but money is important, yeah. And I know it's wrong, most people don't chase money, but I like
no,
to chase
I think
money.
Most of people chase money, but
they don't admit it.
They don't admit it.
They don't say like money, yeah, but you're chasing success, which will come with money, right?
Yeah.
A lot of things become easier in life.
Exactly. So money for me is important.
Yeah.
For many people, it's not, and they say it also, okay, but not for me. And yeah, success and money, which is not a very nice thing to say, money,
no,
but
just being honest.
I like it.
And
I
for you, Aneri?
Of course, success is the first thing. That you have to chase success, because success is never going to chase you. So you have to be that first person to chase success, because there are a lot of people who are chasing success and not telling it to you all. But everybody wants to be successful in life. And the other thing is, I want to chase for just not being stressed about anything, and I want to chase for a carefree life.
Ah, that's an amazing
that's nice,
goal.
Nice,
yeah,
nice,
yeah, I want to chase
that's
for a carefree life where, you know, everything is just very sorted, which is not really...
We're quite carefree now also, Aneri.
Yeah, I've always been carefree, but I'm carefree, and also that I keep thinking about it. Okay, have I done this? Okay, am I
you're
okay?
Getting there soon, don't worry about
no,
it.
Carefree.
So, have you ever thought of giving up?
No.
No. Never.
And now that we've discussed what are the two most important things in life to chase, if you have to choose between success and love, what would you pick?
You're waiting for me to answer, then you'll answer?
Yeah, I'm thinking.
Think.
Quite a tough one, yeah? Success.
And then you go first. Ladies
first.
I have my answer ready.
Okay, Mishkat.
It's not tough for me at all.
Success.
No,
I think I would have said success also, but then I realized that I can't live without love. I will not be successful if I'm not loved.
When you're successful, everything comes
no,
your
no,
way.
No. If I'm loved,
I'm
I will
cool,
try to be.
But yeah.
I know, but if I am like if I'm loved, I will go. I will be a happier person, and I think being happy is the most important thing.
Yeah.
If you're not happy and if you have success, what's the use?
So, I mean, having talked about what is more important in life, and for you both, it's success, which is universal actually. And how much important it is over love also, given all that. In your life, what has been that one darkest moment where you thought you lost hope? And you eventually found light. And how did it happen?
Okay, so after I finished Nisha's cousins, I don't know, I was not overconfident, but I was really confident that I will not have to, you know, look out for work, or I will not have to wait.
Ask me about it.
I really had a strong feeling that people will, because I remember when I was doing Nisha's Cousins, a lot of people used to keep appreciating, and you know, I was feeling really good about it. So I thought
it was a shocker that
I thought that Nisha's Cousins, I will not wait, like maybe in a month I'll start shooting.
And it didn't happen.
Not because, of course I got a lot of work, but then I was also being choosy, and where I was not being choosy, I would not get that.
Yeah.
So for like a year, I didn't do anything. So I was really taken aback that moment that, oh shit, like what is happening with me? I just did a really good show, and now I at least deserved of that no waiting time and like just getting something. But then that eventually happened later when I did Behad. So yeah.
And for you, Mishkat?
The darkest phase in my life. Post my last show, there were three things gonna happen for me. Work, love, and something else, which I think my house. And all three were going to happen at the same time. And I was like, shit, this is perfect. Is this going to actually happen? It's too good to be true that I'm going to be with someone, get some really good work, and also buy my flat, which I've been waiting for. So, eventually nothing happened in a week. It was supposed to happen next week. All three were.
Oh my.
Nothing happened.
So, how did you find light in that darkness?
See, I have an amazing family here. And I always said this, I've never had any pressure from my parents to work or do something in their life, even though I'm a guy and generally guys have to work, and actors, you know, kaisa hota hai. Most of the time they're doing nothing. So my parents generally, whenever I had a dark phase in my life, and I think it's my parents who just like treat it as if it's nothing, like it's okay. Don't think about it. Just go to your stuff, go to your auditions, go to your extracurricular activities and just push through it. It's normal. Like, you're lucky that you have two hands and two legs. So, yeah.
Yes. As long as you have the right support system around you can conquer anything.
That's really important. Yeah. All these people who want to be actors, all the parents who have children who want to be actors, just support them. And I don't give them a deadline like 1 year, 2 years.
Yeah, because the biggest challenge is the daily rejection you face at every level.
Yeah.
Like, you go to the gym, you think you're like 10 on 10. Suddenly, you see 10 people who are 11 on 10.
Why are actors only called strugglers?
Yeah.
That's ridiculous. Someone wants to be a doctor.
They're struggling.
They struggle more than us. Yeah. We struggle with luxury.
But tagline that strugglers is actors.
Yeah, that's ridiculous. That's what I always hear. Like, every guy, he doesn't become something.
We all
a struggle
are trying
in every profession.
To make sense of life.
Exactly.
And that is what we all are doing.
Like
today.
A director,
and living a dream.
Yeah.
An aspiring director is a struggler. An aspiring doctor is a struggler. An aspiring lawyer is a struggler.
Yeah.
No, actors are not strugglers. Like, they are, but they are
we
not.
We all are in it
exactly.
together.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
so with that, we move to our next segment, which is Let's Improvise. So this is really where your talent
Let's
comes
improvise.
Out. Yes.
Talent
we'll be improvising. So I'll give you a situation. You will take on from there. And keep 1 year towards me because I'm going to change the conditions and you will follow forth, right? So, Mishka, you're a cabbie, a cab driver. Aneri, you are riding in the cab. Now, Mishka is a sida sada cab driver doing his job, but Aneri is flirtatious. Action.
Benji ka jayenge aap?
Pehle mujhe Benji na bulaye. Call me by my name,
Aneri. नहीं आप तो हमारी बहन जैसी हमारे गांव में
शक्ल देखो मेरी मैं तुम्हारी बहन लगती हूँ गधे
नहीं इसलिए आपको बहन बुलाया शक्ल देख के
ये जो आप बोल रहे हो ना उससे आपको कोई पैसे नहीं मिलेंगे आपको मुझे फ्री में ले जाना पड़ेगा यू श्योर
नहीं मैडम आप प्लीज सर आप बैठिए यहाँ पे
मैं तो बैठी हूँ
मिस्का टेल यू प्रोफेशनलिज्म इज अटमोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट
मैडम प्लीज हाथ अपने पास रखिए ये हमारे संस्कार नहीं है
मेरे संस्कार है फ्लर्ट करना
दिख रहा है
फ्लर्ट करूंगी आपके
मैडम प्लीज मैं आपसे आखिरी बार कह रहा हूं
ओके द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स आर ऑपोजिट मिस्कत यू आर फ्लर्टिंग एंड अनेरी यू आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड एट ऑल
क्या चीज कट फेस मैडम कहां जाएंगी आप
लिसन लिसनिंग
कहाँ जाएंगी?
यहाँ तो बिल्कुल नहीं आऊंगी.
थोड़ा नीचे चले जाइए.
Not interested at all.
मैडम
कहाँ जाना? अच्छी दी नहीं है, बातें तो अच्छी कर लिया करो.
आपके लिए ठीक ठाक है भाई, शुक्र. जाना कहाँ है आपको?
Okay, so both of you are husband wife. Do not get along at all. You can stop driving.
Okay, I'm gonna cabin it
over here. So both of you are husband wife who do not get along at all, but you are at a social dinner. And of course, for the social dinner, you are madly in love.
Hello ma'am. Hi, how's it going?
How are you? Good.
You're a bit mature, right? We are old people.
Yeah, don't disturb
me. Hi, how's it going? Yeah, all good?
Yeah.
Isn't she looking lovely?
Cool color, yeah.
Yeah? Oh baby. Little puppy, kya kar rahi hai?
Okay. You both come back home. Yeah. And you realize that kisi ne bathroom mein
kiss you. No, okay.
So you both come back home and you realize kisi ne bathroom mein nal khula chhod diya tha. Now you both are defending that it wasn't you, it was the other person.
Are you like mad? Kitni baar kaha hai ki bathroom ka nal khula mat rakho?
Maine khula rakha. Main tatti ki haath dhoye nal band kiya, bathroom ke bahar aa gaya. Tum andar
gayi. Language, Mishkat, language.
Tum tatti nahi karti, tatti karne mein kya buri baat hai?
Washroom. That's why I hate you.
हिंदी में उसे संडास बोलते हैं।
अपनी ऑक्स ना यहाँ पर मत दिखाओ। ऑक्स इज औकात।
Oh my God, that was one good Jew moment.
Okay,
let's take a pause here.
That was Nishant's cousins.
Okay. So now, Mishkat, you're a director. You're shooting a full-fledged, big-budget film, and she's the heroine of the film, and she's a diva. She throws a diva fit at everything. You cannot get angry, but you have to get the work done. Action.
मैडम आप रेडी हो? मैम
एक्सक्यूज मी, मेकअप है?
मेकअप मैडम अगला शॉट ये है कि
आप दूर से बात करेंगे प्लीज?
जी और दूर ठीक है?
हां प्लीज डोंट टच मी. ओके सैनिटाइजर प्लीज.
मैडम अगला सीन ये है कि आप यहां से चल के आएंगी, नीचे उतरेंगी.
नहीं पर मैं यहां से निकलना चाहूंगी. आई वांट टू वॉक फ्रॉम हियर. सो जस्ट चेंज द कैमरा.
ठीक है हां. ए कैमरा बदल ले. मैडम आप यहाँ से चल के आएंगी, नीचे आएंगी, ठीक है? आप फिर इधर आएंगी.
नहीं वहाँ पे नहीं, मैं वहाँ पे आऊंगी.
हाँ ठीक है. नहीं मैडम क्या, आप यहाँ पे खड़े होंगी, ठीक है? हीरो आएगा आपके पास और मैडम
एक्चुअली आई वांट टू जस्ट रिप्लेस द हीरो. आई डोंट थिंक ही इज, यू नो.
मैडम वो प्रोड्यूसर का बेटा है.
सो आई एक्चुअली डोंट केयर. डिसाइड कीजिए क्या मैं और दूंगी विभू.
आपको कोई हरी आंखों वाला चाहिए या फिर?
Oh my God, you both are amazing. I mean, that was fabulous. So, oh my God, that's called impromptu talent.
Go on. Yeah.
So with that, we move to our next segment, which is specially for these two, where we are going to be testing the IQ.
Yeah, you can't do it.
Listen, I'm also really smart. Huh?
You are smart.
I'm smart compared to you. Yeah. That's okay.
I'll give you a pass. I'm just kidding. And there's no IQ test happening.
Sure.
I told Aneri ahead of time.
Hey, so Aneri makes me feel really intelligent, which I'm really not. Because for my friends, I'm a dumbass.
Okay, I want to tell this to everybody now. So, Unwrap with Vibhu will probably get to know one more thing about me. That I'm a dyslexic.
Yeah, that she genuinely is.
Yeah, I'm genuinely a dyslexic. So, now don't laugh on
me. Sare guna maaf.
Thank you.
So, what is that one mantra you live by at the moment?
Pagalu baal. I was doing bichari, you know.
No, he was doing both.
Oh.
No. That's why the baal is nikal raha.
So, what is the mantra you live by at the moment?
Oh, God.
Mantra I live at the moment. I think earlier I used to think a lot about what's going to happen in the future, But it's been few months that I don't think about what's going to happen in the future and I live in my present. Like, I just enjoy everything that is with me at the moment. I enjoy whoever's with me. Yeah, I see, I'm enjoying this. I'm not thinking about what I'm going to do. Like, I'm just living in the moment. And I think that's my mantra, these days at least.
For you, Mishkat?
अब एक कुछ ऐसा अतरंगी कुछ तो बोलेगा.
मैं सोच रहा हूँ क्या बोलूँ यार. मंत्र these days. Just this feels really low for me. whatever I'm in right now.
You'll be fine.
So no, this fine. Is, so in this low phase of mine, I have to put in even more effort. That's my mantra now.
Especially you're a blessed child. You'll be fine.
Am I?
You're a blessed child. You'll be fine.
Yeah, yeah, man.
No, ऐसा नहीं है.
तू है तुझे पता ना?
Y'all, Sonny, your mom, bloody your parents give your life for you, man. Just shut up. You're ungrateful.
I'm ungrateful?
Next.
I'm ungrateful?
Yes. Mom calls.
Slap. Imagine, Mishkat, you only saw that day. Mom called me up in 10 minutes, 10 times.
So what?
Achha.
When you were a small kid.
When your mom
calls you, not 10 But dad, when you were a kid, your papa was one. He had 100 questions you had. And now he'll ask me, phone kaise kya papa kaho
mujhe acha si same na same
that's very wrong you should change
so with that we move to our last segment which is
khatam mat
this adorable no. thing which I bring out for my guests so fight for this is for you
thank you
and Mishkat for you this is
isko kya aise diya
male grooming kit by the man company
how sweet
kya ye
man company
mere ko
chahiye these are man products
khol le to
I want to see
So guys, thanks a lot for watching and we'll see you in the next episode. I think I like it. Audio theek tha? Did we get it?
Are you still rolling? You like it before I take off my t-shirt?
Yeah,
not
yeah,
take
yeah.
my t-shirt.
Come on,
yeah,
come on,
go,
come,
go,
on,
go,
on
go,
come on.
Take off.
Okay, you do it too.
I do it, you do it.
No, you do it too.
No, no.
no.
no. no.
no.
no.
As long as he does it, I'll do it.
I will make him do it.